is buying a condo a good investment? Well, that all depends on what kind of investor are you and what do you want to accomplish. For example, some investors are only interested in the actual equity investment for the future. And that really means that what they want to do is they want to invest some money into a real estate condo, for example, and just rent it out and be happy as long as it pays for itself and they don't have to add money out of pocket for maintaining this condo. They're happy with that. There are some investors who are actually looking to ROI, which basically means what's their return on investment. And then there's other investors who are looking for positive cash flow. So let's analyze this specific condo that I have in mind for you today, which is 175 Zoe Street, apartment 5S in Staten Island, New York, in a beautiful Manhattan style, very unique design building. So let's analyze this particular condo that happens to be for sale currently at 175 Zoe Street, unit 5S, Staten Island, New York, 10305, Dongan Hills, one of the most desirable areas on Staten Island, conveniently located with really at your doorsteps, few blocks away from transportation, few blocks away from shopping, and even the Staten Island Railway, which takes you from Tottenville to the ferry, from the ferry to Tottenville. So this particular condo is listed at $259,000. Now, if you're a conventional buyer, we would assume that you would put a down payment of 20%. So let's do the math. With 20% down, which equals $51,800, you would then would borrow a loan amount of $207,200. Now, let's assume that you are buying it for investment purposes. Then we will guesstimate that your loan amount would be at an interest of 4%. It might be a little less, but let's take 4% for this particular math calculation. With 4% interest on a $207,000 loan, your principal and interest monthly payment would be $988.25. Not bad at all. So, however, there are some other expenses that are associated with the condo. One being the maintenance, monthly maintenance fee, plus let's not forget the real estate taxes. Okay, so in this particular condo, you get some perks with the homeowners association maintenance fee, which includes some of the utilities. So you get the water, the hot water, the heating, and the gas included in your maintenance fee. The maintenance fee happens to be very low on this condo building, and it is $243.33 a month. Now, the property taxes comes out to a monthly payment of $159, brings you a monthly payment between the real estate taxes and the homeowners association maintenance fee to a total of $373.33. Not bad. So let's add those numbers together. Let's add those numbers together. It comes out, if you add the $988.25 plus the $214.33 for the maintenance fees that are also including some of your utilities and the property tax monthly payment, your total payment comes up to $1,361.58. Well, let's think about what can you rent this condo for. This condo can be rented for $1,500 a month. So if we take $1,500 a month for the rent minus $1,361.58, which is going to be totaling all of your expenses, meaning mortgage payment, principal and interest, property taxes, and your homeowners association fee, you would net
a positive cash flow of $138.42. Not bad, right? Here's another way we can analyze this. Now, let's say that you are actually buying a condo to live in. Well, let's compare. Again, if you were to rent this condo out for yourself, you would be paying $1,500 a month rent. Now, let's calculate it if you were to own it instead of paying rent. Here's how the numbers would look. Let's take the same example. Let's say you're a conventional buyer. So the list price of this condo is $259. 20% would give you $51,800. So you would still borrow $207,200 for your loan amount. Now, because you're buying it for yourself and you're going to be living in it, and assuming your credit is good, then your mortgage interest rate would be somewhere in the realm of 3%. It could be less, could be a little more, but let's take a safety net and say 3%. A 3% mortgage, your principal and interest would be $872.72. Now, can you believe this? Paying rent $1,500 or $872.72 and owning the property? Now, let's not forget, you're still gonna have your $214.33 for the maintenance fee. Don't forget, some of the utilities are included, and you're going to be paying for your property taxes, which a total monthly payment for that is $373.33. Now, let's do the math. If you're buying this condo to live in, $872.72 is your principal and interest mortgage payment, plus $214.33 for your homeowners associations, plus $159 for your property taxes, not to mention that you are building your own equity in your own property for the future. Your monthly payment would be $1,246.05, which is still a lot less than paying rent of $1,500 a month. Well, stick around if you're interested in this condo. Stick around, I will show you a virtual video tour of this condo. And if you felt that this is something that you'd be interested in either investing in or making a purchase for your real estate future, don't hesitate to contact us at 917-579-4455. Send us a message, make a comment, ask us a question, and don't forget to like our video, click on the bell to make sure you always notified when we post a new video. And if you're interested in schedule a private viewing for this condo, please let us know.